structure will be in order. The space criticism, the security gate. Second will be the space bill this end. And then, if my speed hasn't failed me, the China part of the case will be on bottom.
Good luck, Patrick.
Good luck. Here we are again.
You ready or what? What's going on here? Why is it talking? Hold on.
Two easy number one is a framework by kind of interpretation. The negative gets into the negative, gets any form of criticism. The applicant's the way that case gets to solve all of your limitations, the education advantage. We solve your pragmatism arguments because we can have policy arguments that would include the ability for us to have criticism and alternative reveal. All right. That would be able to have access to the way that we have pragmatism. This solves your Guzzini evidence. Your number two argument is the case that waits for your warming evidence, but all the alternative can solve every portion by your. Except for your China disadvantage. You have not read a reason why this is not so. Our argument is not incompatible with the planets and it's incompatible with our McDonald evidence and our Brown evidence. We represent China, which means that the logical result of our alternative could still be cooperation of the result of physics question. Your next argument is the case outweighs debate, but this is not true. The attempt to assert U.S. dominance of space creates a dangerous new empire space, one in which sovereignty of all the nations disappears. This creates a moment of bare life where we can reduce everyone to nothing. This is Duval Hovcraft 2008. The effect of space weapons erases out of sovereignty. Persistent space strikes happen so rapidly that defense for the hospital is not possible. The shape of the defense hard shell that classical realist arguments constitute of sovereignty application of force from the world space would constitute the center of a global existence of empire. These weapons would strip the states of their territorial of territorial sovereignty. Sovereignty states would no longer be an obstacle to killing enemies. These weapons can target anyone, anywhere, at any time, anywhere out there. It's effectively reduced to bare last ever power determines who's outside the law of protecting the state in relationship to the inclusive exclusion states other than exceptional American state are reduced to empty shells without the jure of sovereignty. Your next argument is evolutionary biology, but Thayer is wrong. His interpretation about evolution is incorrect. This is Einhard, who doesn't deny Thayer believes that organism evolves a larger set of wants. The gene 2 problems biology is more than genetics. Studying the genes by themselves will tell what tells almost anything about politics. Thayer does downplay the importance of environment or culture as problems and causes. We need a science from nature that studies evolution of many causes at many levels of consistency. Your next argument is the permutation to do both, but obviously this would not be able to solve the alternative. Your representations you are stuck with also this is a link to your planets, which means it's not compatible with our alternative. Your representations of China are specifically bad shift in 2007, the right to ensure maintenance and security while denying adversaries access to space system and empire by environment of have and have nots in space. The situation is not an obvious and unfair strategic advantage of space. The U.S. specifically leads the global community to suspect new laws while suffering the space portal examination of its conduct, serious invitation to dissuade other countries, including China, from possessing space capabilities and program that would effectively dislodge China, possessing the minimum service of national defense and space security environment of one which rests on rules for the United States and other sets of rules of nations. Only U.S. security concerns are taken into account. Your next argument is that you're not racist, but this is answered by the way that you've answered the China made. I'll get to that in a second. Your next argument is the number six argument. Permutation to do the plan without representation. This is blatant severance. You have chosen the representation that you go with this. That's where you have to defend them. Your number seven argument is that threats are ruining your convincing evidence, but you have not read any specific evidence about why this is true in the context of China. We are winning this debate on the other part of the case law, which is the reason why you are voting negative. The next part is the realism debate. You say that realism is the best for Sheehan, but your Sheehan evidence in the other portion says that cooperation is the best way and that a realist would invite cooperation, not competition with the way that we have China. Thus, we are controlling the inevitability of it because we, as economic thinkers, can control this. Grinding the six promises within the relation that thinks a territorial space to a political space, the analytical framework, none of the critical geopolitics, language, policy, does not simply reflect real policy issues. Problem is that it actually produces the issue in which problems to deal and reflect the specific problems that they confront in critical geopolitics, a traditional approach that still believes that prefer you often be a part of politics. Group the rest of realism, make your focus on realism is inaccurate and reduces action to the motive that creates inaccurate predictions. We can have cooperation, that's our grinding alternative. This is Spiegel 2007. Despite insights that evolution and biology can be another question of reducing or not in such disciplines, persons have no real essence. The understanding of counter-relation has important methodological implications. The international periodic theorems cannot bypass the self-understanding which would weigh by political roles, development, constant schemes of application. There would be no question of reducing explanation the international relations to biological explanations. The next part of the debate is you say that the alternative cannot solve that's your number 10 argument, but this is our grounded evidence that indicates that we can have cooperation-based arguments. You say conditionality is bad, but counter-condition, then it gets one conditional counterpoint, solves all the multiple world arguments and minimizes their offense. First, is our offense is created two-way critical thinking, the answer to anticipate negative block energy, which forces them to critter, I have critical judgments about the run. I know sped for education increases the breadth of education by a different argument. This bow does not solve this argument because the next can add extra chemical blanks to force and force permutation. This bow is conditionality. It's illogical to vote for a policy that is worse than the status quo. And there is a type of judgment school never will you have the first life speech, which is the reason why we are winning this part of the space mill.
Oh, yeah. Floating pits.
Our interpretation is we get a floating pit, but we have a consistent textual advocacy. We simply reject the logic of security. We see our evidence is contextual to the plans of China. We can have a political net benefit to our education, which is better for policymakers for us to apply these forms of criticism. This is also consistent because policymakers do this all the time when they criticize the modernism that adopted. Go to the space bill debate. Do all my hypercraft evidence is good enough to answer this part, to answer this link argument? These are that we've gone before, but we have unique substances that we slowed down and indicate that we have formed pacts with the EU, etc. Which answers the argument. You say that weaponization now, but our hypercraft evidence is just better about like continuous space exploration will cause us to go over the brink. There's a specific link also to Helium 3. This is Gagnon 2006. Helium 3 can forth over $3 billion, matching the rest of the gold of the moon. Special force will implement miniature pack bills and commercial interest, create offensive space weapons and systems, thus control the shipping lanes to the moon and beyond. There's development of military air connection, yes, moon missions. NASA plan to establish permanent base on the moon, while military control and dominate access to extract valuable resources from the moon. And years had our evidence is more than good enough. You say that weaponization now, but our Luke evidence is good enough to say that no space mobilization exists in status quo because of EU-US trade barriers. And there's more evidence that this is not happening. Not in New York. This is New York Times in 2010. Obama unveiled a space policy that emphasized a national cooperation, including arms control treaty that would limit space weapons. Obama administration has stopped the saber rattling and several might be ended in a new peaceful accord through the plenty of caveats and big conditions. And no weaponization for China or Russia now. RII 2010, Russia had no plans to deploy weapons. There are no offer for orbital space to deploy weapons. They have agreements that prohibit the weapons of mass destruction being placed into space. And known before China as well. This is Harmeal 2010, right by Russia and China 2008, the most prominent proposal to fill in the normative void in the current space of security trade between the perils inherent to the perils inherent to instrument weaponization business compared comparable to that of nuclear weapons. The PPW nuclear triad treaty introduced in the CD in February has been touted as a practical way to nip the ball of perils in the butt. You say militarization is inevitable. This is not true. We have the ability to control. Right now, this is about public perception. This is Domina Miller, 2006. People with engineering backgrounds have a tendency to say space is already weaponized. It's a multiplicity because we use GPS. That may be technically correct, but it's totally irrelevant because this is what about what the public believes. Impact debate. Group it. I'll be into the impact debate. Don't sass me. The Mitchell evidence as well says weaponization creates war and extinction. The orbiting death stars, as evidence indicates, have a high trigger alert, which is the brink that your uniqueness presses have not come to grips with. The litany of close calls with nuclear systems have happened in the past. This will amplify the risk of accidents. This also means that your impacts of war are inevitable, which means the F is inevitable. We ultimately turn your turn the case because there's no impact to argument. This then turns the case space weaponization miscount causes the U.S. to strike China. This is Lewis for Chinese assets or circumstantial evidence could not admit the Chinese programs have not been identified for certain by personal cannot be confirmed gaps in the U.S. knowledge or dangerous. The fact that China might already have such a system would create a sorry incident for the U.S. space system before they were lost and not too far to strike. Imagine the president deciding we cannot wait for the final proof that will come in the form of a mushroom cone. This is extinction straight time 2000 conflict would embroil countries race plus but a nuclear war incident would set on fire with 30-20 in effect that can create a new dangerous base. China plus 20 nuclear war has a base incident to prepare to go forward from the nuclear option. We would see the direction of civilization. Nuclear war against China cannot be ruled out. Your next argument is Indo-Pakistan, but this is not true. Weaponization would disrupt disarmament. Issues that are happening in status quo. This is sweet. Apply space weaponization with zero and disrupt the arms control and disarmament process. China would like being forced to be filled more war ads, which could in turn encourage Indian Pakistan to follow suit. And there's no risk of your solvency for extinction because you ignore that space weaponization would lead to debris. This is Wickersham 2010. The most troubling aspects of mass amounts of space debris, orbital cutting could become worse if the logical space weapons are placed into LEO. If your weapons wide, a dangerous space debris, only left room for peace, civilian systems, civilian centers will be destroyed. The debris will cause chaos and trip to the internet, resulting in a breakdown of communications involving financial, health, security, environmental, and other sensitive operations necessary to our life on the planet.